eSportBets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. eSportBets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
All right, the ladies and the gentlemen, welcome back to the show. We've got the last match of the evening between Reason, or unu AiN, which they've been renamed as, and Epsilon. It's a best of one game, SLTV Starseries, and thank you very much for tuning in to us. And of course, I am so fortunate to have Hiko with me. Hiko, how have you been enjoying your evening here on the stream?
After that last game, definitely. Definitely has been a good evening for Counter-Strike. A lot of good matches, a lot of good matchups.
Yeah, it's been interesting, right? I mean, we've definitely seen some shocks. I was surprised that that Epsilon lost to Fnatic on Mirage. I was even more surprised when Epsilon destroyed VODS Pro on this very map here on Inferno just before. So I don't know what to say. I guess what it all boils down to is that best of one online matches are a little bit unpredictable at times.
Yeah, definitely. But I mean, at the same time, Epsilon definitely gave VODS Pro a plowing.
Oh, you're right. Exactly right. Well, yeah, it turns around on them, apparently. Unfortunate for them. But I'm sure they'll be back stronger than ever, come the next couple of tournaments here. Obviously, the Gfinity LAN and also Gamescom, which is coming up both in the next month and with not that much break between them. It's going to be interesting. If you're just joining us, then welcome very much to the stream. I hope you guys are going to click the Facebook link at the bottom of the page where you can win a SOE keyboard. Really, really great one. And all you have to do is like the page and you'll be good to go. Also, hope you're going to follow the channel. I think we're almost at 140,000 followers, which would be huge for us. That would be a really great mark. If we could hit that tonight, that would be insane. But we have to do something else, guys. So we've been trying to get Hiko more followers on Twitter, and there's a good reason why you should follow Hiko. First of all, he's a really friendly guy, but also he does a lot of streaming, and if you follow him on Twitter and he streams and he does giveaways, you guys can be the first to know, and you can go and participate in those giveaways, so it's definitely worth it. Now, we have him at 10,201 followers, but considering the fact that we have 15,000 people watching, some of you must or not be following him. So go and click the button. We'll put the link here in the chat to his Twitter, just so people know where it's at. And I hope you guys are going to go and click that follow button, because that is really nice. Hiko, I know you even gave up streaming on your own channel a little bit early to come and join us here. So I hope you guys are going to repay him a little bit for doing that. I really appreciate that.
I appreciate it too. It's always fun coming here. And actually, this is my first time since your name change, your split.
Yeah, because you've been on NIPTV quite a bit. You were actually I would almost go as far as saying you were like one of the frequent guests coming on. So it's nice to have you back.
Well, thank you. It's always good to be with you, Anders. It's always a good time.
It is. I always enjoy it as well. We have 10 people on the server, so we just need the go, and then we'll be ready. Now, this match, especially based on the last game, which we've already sort of proven, scientifically proved, that using chain logic to bet on is really dangerous. And this game, you can't even bet on it, so it doesn't really even matter. But if you were to bet on this game based on the last one, you might be making a mistake. But I still feel like the difference between VODS Pro and unu AiN here, or the former Reason lineup, is almost as big as the one between VODS Pro and USSR. Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, the only person I know of on unu AiN is MSL. I think maybe Tensk. I've heard of before. Yeah, Tensk I think I've heard, but the other three, I don't think I've ever seen them anywhere.
I think PNX and Hunden, you'd have to be following the Danish scene a little bit closely. I think maybe if you are Danish and you follow some of the teams, you'll know them. But they are sort of they're halfway recognizable faces, I'd say. Kevin, I think you would only know if you were like a big big fan of Source, because apparently he was a pretty good AWPer in the Danish scene in Counter-Strike Source. At least that's what I've been told. But I think you're right. Tensky and MSL are the big names here on this lineup. We'll see if they can make a difference. It's going to be a best of one game, SLTV Star Series Season 10. You're at Room on Fire. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I hope you guys are going to subscribe and follow and just enjoy the show more than anything else here. It's going to be on Inferno, and we've got myself and Hiko broadcasting this game. If you're joining us from YouTube, which if you guys didn't know, we actually do have a YouTube channel with all the VODs on, then thank you for tuning in as well, and hope you're going to enjoy the YouTube channel.
Already on the pistol round. They didn't get a single kill.
Oh.
This is already... Or the knife run, excuse me. This is already starting pretty poorly.
Oh, hopefully it's not going to be like a 16-0 victory. Hopefully, I mean, they just lost their organization in Reason. I think Reason sort of gave up on them or the other way around. I'm not sure what happened. Actually, I've just given up on following, you know, news about Danish teams because they change so often that it's almost not worth it. And yeah, I'm saying that as, you know, someone from Denmark. So I'm not even trying to be mean here.
Well, you have Dignitas, right? They've been Dignitas for a while, so...
Oh, thank God, yes, we have
Dignitas. There's at least one of them.
I'm actually pretty excited about the Copenhagen Wolves lineup. I think that's going to be a really fun team to watch. But now, the game is on here. GMX with the one, with the two, instant headshots going in, Shoxi and FXJO, and... Wow!
Well, the two rounds in a row now, if you include Knife, where not a singular kill went for unu AiN. Already starting off pretty grim.
Yes, I think Grim
I don't think it did any damage. I actually think all five people in Epsilon had 100 HP left at the end of that too.
Yes, that was that was a crushing defeat. Well, Epsilon are probably feeling a little bit fired up as well. Wouldn't be surprised if they are, you know, feeling confident, feeling pretty good about that last game that they just played. Kiyoshima is going to be here with a Nova shotgun. Actually, he does not enough damage with the first shot there. Trying to fall back to safety. He's going to get some help from Superfighter, who picks up the two kills. And then, you know, it's all safe and sound afterwards.
Yeah. No, nothing really unu AiN can do at this point. Might as well feed.
Might as well just feed some kills. And Shoxi's a good person to be feeding as well, you know.
Yeah.
Kevin coming in with a kill, and it's about time that Danish team picked up one. Shotgun not going to be used for anything. And Tensky here, not a big chance unless... Well, actually, he just made some noise, so now they know exactly where he is, and that is even worse, actually. Ah, well, I mean, we were talking about it earlier. What happens when you're facing up against a team that's much better than you are, and, you know, you want to try and take something away from it, apart from just, you know, the fact that they're better. You want to try and learn and adjust, and you said... The best way of doing that is if you've actually already prepared for it. So if you've prepared playing Inferno against Epsilon, maybe you have a chance. And actually, the Danish team would have had a chance of watching the game. Do you think that could help them a little bit?
I think so. I think Epsilon would play a lot differently now against unu AiN than they would against Virtus Pro. But they should have definitely caught on to some tendencies. CT is a little bit harder to play around because... I mean, Epsilon doesn't do anything crazy, like just push something every round, or nobody plays the same spot every round. There's a B-Rush coming now.
Yeah, Famas doing good work here, and actually the pistol super fighter, please, gets a quad kill before it's all over. He's down to 16. Kiyoshima just snagged one of the kills in between, but it looked like that push could have done a lot more.
Yeah, I would think so.
Just, I mean, when... FAMAS is not really the ideal weapon. Whenever someone has a FAMAS or an M4A1, which is a weapon that both Hiko and I think have a disliking of, but if you get caught too close, you can end up, you know, just not doing enough damage or running out of bullets. But they did just fine.
They did.
I remember correctly, you're not a big fan of the M4A1 either, right?
I mean, I use both. I switch back and forth a lot.
All right, fair enough. I seem to remember you not appreciating it, but... flashbang smoke running through SF, charging on in, and actually the whole Danish team is just waiting for him, so this is a really good take at the bombsite. We're now in a 3-on-4, and FXJO just charging in, gonna get the one kill, but I think this is Epsilon playing without any respect for the Danish team. They just want to see if they can actually wow everyone here and get some great kills in. Smoke in the back means Tensky probably has to move eventually, but he's sitting put for now, gonna spot two people there, GMX, so a lot of information gained, but he's also down to 7 HP, and this is gonna be a really tough retake, no matter how you put it. Shoxi smoking off here. Oh, he's gonna go for the defuse, you gotta be joking. The defuse is happening, no, he goes down, and Shoxi tries to bring it back here, does get a double, no, just the one kill, and they hold on to it.
Close. Very close for Epsilon. I like what they did too. They had a smoke off at the emo spot, which is the back spot, and then they had another smoke that went to the close side of try boxes.
Yeah.
So, and then they had another smoke for the bomb. So I feel like if they played it a little bit better, they might have been able to win it, but good round by whoever it was that killed the planner. Or like the diffuser, excuse me.
Exactly. Wow, that was scary, but good way of holding at the end there from the Danish team, but also like the fact that they managed to get that opening pick at least and you know actually commit to the bomb site. That was good of them to see that opening.
Yeah. I think they just threw like one flash and they took it again too.
Oh, FXYO nearly getting caught, and actually GMX will go down. Hunden taking that kill. So something is working here for unu AiN, which is good. Definitely very good. Shoxi down in the pit, strong position for him, and actually gonna get taken down. MSL jumping with the AK, and we've already discussed this once before. You're not really supposed to jump and shoot in Global Offensive unless maybe you have a shotgun or a scout, but definitely not an AK, but that worked out great.
It did. You got the kill from it too.
FXYO, well, he's sort of covering the bomb, gonna pick off one, and then turns around, doesn't get that shot, and he's gonna be going down. Good pick off there. Hunden with a really good round, picking off two kills, I believe. So nicely done. 3-2, and Epsilon are back to ecoing.
Yeah, so unu AiN threw a smoke in the arches and in library, and they had a guy walk through the smoke and get to the right next to library, just through the smoke. So he was able to catch off, I think it was GMX just running out off guard. And there was another guy that was camping the halls waiting for the guy to push around, and he got another like free kill in there too. So it actually was pretty good reading and pretty good movement there by unu AiN.
I mean, this is strange, right? But already it seems like the Danes are actually playing a little bit better than VODS Pro. Where on this map, that's one deke from Kiyoshima onto Hunden, which is, you know, a painful way to be ended, but a really nice one.
You can just kind of tell, like, they should have saved this round, but instead they have deagles, shotguns, CZs. So this is what you do when you don't really respect the team you're playing, I feel.
Yeah, it is looking that way. And with a one dig like that, and especially if Shoxi can pick up this kill on Tenski, who is, you know, they're having a bit of a duel, even though none of them know it, but it is going to go down there eventually. Another dig coming out here from Kiyoshima. No, he's going to miss that one. SF goes down, and now is the push going to be happening? I'm still keeping my eye on the minimap looking for Tenski, but he's going to be walking back. So it's going to be maybe FXYO, CSET 75 in hand, shoots with the smoke, not quite enough. Kiyoshima misses another one here, and now they're rotating more people in. Oh, what is happening? Danish team really picking slowly. Oh, Shox in the middle. Gonna take down one. If he had hit the first shot, maybe he could have killed PNX as well. Now the bomb is gonna go down in this bomb site, and it's still a 3-on-3.
GMAX rushes the site. He might be able to kill the planner. Maybe?
Shotgun close range here, looking for the headshot. PNX gotta just stay ducked. If he stands up, well, he's gonna pick up the kill. Nicely done, and Kiyoshima won't find. Well, he actually did pick up a second kill. That's also a headshot, but it's not enough here. PNX with a quad kill and a very good round again for unu AiN, but still, I think a little bit too close for comfort considering what equipment Epsilon had that round.
Yeah, I mean, now they're putting themselves in a better position. All five of them only have body armor. None of them have head armor right now. Which I know there's people like to say, well, if you get headshotted with an AK, it's a one shot anyway. But still, there's a lot of boxes people hide behind, especially on this map. Where if you don't have head armor and you're getting headshotted through a box, it hurts. It's a lot of damage to take.
Look at how they're walking up here, flashing through the smoke. Danish team, that's a really great execute. I love that. They didn't do too much behind it, which is unfortunate, but the idea itself is a really smart one. Unfortunately, now there are two people down already. Kevin and also PNX going down. Tenski will fall. MSL, and there is now going to be Hunden left in a 1-on-4 here. So, in spite of that idea, it doesn't really work out. But I still think it's a solid plan that they came up with here.
It should have worked. I think FXYO got pretty lucky he got out. He got shot to like 19 HP and fell back into arches, and then I think it was, I don't know who it was, but somebody rounded the corner and just missed him. Yeah. And then by that time, Shoxi was already at the mini pit, and he just traded right after. So I would have expected unu AiN to get a couple more kills that round, maybe even get the bomb planted, but again, FXYO just, you know, got away kind of luckily and was able to hold them all off.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. That would have been the round lead as well for the Danes. Instead, now they're at a one-round deficit, and even worse still, they're ecoing, so they didn't get the bomb plant last round. Probably not going to get it this time either from the setup that we're watching here. Kiyoshima has a grenade out. SF's actually going to spot the grenade. Look at him just tracking it here. Unless they come through, Kiyoshima is ready with death and destruction. PMX is going to go down after getting the one kill, and that is going to be all it takes. 5-3 here, moving in to the ninth round, where The Danes actually have a lot of money to work with here, so I'm... Yeah, they should be buying, I'm going to say. Yeah, they will. But, I mean, what do you think about unu AiN at this point here, Hiko? Are you surprised by how they're playing, or is it roughly the style you're looking for?
I am actually surprised. I didn't expect it to be this close. These runs are actually pretty close, and if a couple more kills happened, I think unu AiN might even be at the lead at this point. But on the same hand, I mean, Epsilon is showing them... You know, no mercy. They're showing them no respect. I mean, you can just tell by the way they're peeking them. Like, they don't expect much from them either. It's definitely, you can definitely tell they're not playing as Words Pro. And it shows just, you know, just their general, the way they peek. I think unu AiN is having a lot of success taking middle. And that's something that Epsilon usually doesn't just give up easily. So, but if they're able to keep doing it, I think these rounds might go a little bit better.
So far, not really working out. They already lose two, and Hunden is very low on health. He's going to be found as well. GMX rotating all the way around. And this guy was, I think MSL was going to be flanking over here, but now he's probably going to get spotted any second by Kiyoshima. Tensky will pick up the one kill, and actually great shot through the smoke there from MSL. And a double kill, very nicely handled, but the bomb is lost, and now it's a weird one-on-one, and this is bad because Shoxi has a lot of time to work with positioning himself, and MSL has almost no time. I mean, 28 seconds. He's going to have to run and gun and just hope to find Shoxi, but he doesn't
have
time.
Does Shoxi know the bomb is down? I mean, I guess he has to if he's staying here. And now MSL will have no idea where Shoxi actually is. He's going to have to run right up mid. Wait. He doesn't have time for this.
No, I was going to say there's no way he can actually put this bomb down. You have to do it when it switches from 5 to 4, yeah.
Right, so he has no time.
Sort of halfway through 4. If you do it, yeah, so nope, not happening. Nope. Time runs out.
It's close, but he can't die now, okay. That's risky to peek into that, because if he dies, he all of a sudden has no gun, no money. I mean, look, he had $1,300 this round. So if he died, he would have put them even at a bigger disadvantage. But luckily, he got the kill. He saved his AK, at least.
Yeah, small victories for the Danes here in the last couple of rounds. Unfortunately, they've lost three in a row, and the rest of the team is ecoing. MSL does have... Man, I guess... I mean, I have to be honest, I didn't know the exact timing of how long it took. It just sort of felt like there wasn't going to be enough time, and I guess MSL was banking on the fact that there might have been. MSL, actually speaking, goes down to Kyushin with a really good wall shot coming out, and PNX and Tensky are now left, and they are getting crushed between the weight of the A and the B bombsite, just pushing in from every angle. Tensky's going to pop up right in the middle of all that chaos and just goes down. Triple from FXGO, 7-3, and it feels like now the Frenchmen are really starting to step it up.
Yep. I'm surprised that FXGO doesn't just op and just pick mid every round, because I don't think anyone on unu AiN has had an op yet. And the way they take middle, I don't think they really smoke it. I think they just like walk up. So I think an op would be pretty useful against a team like this.
You might be right. Well,
this round, of course, they have to smoke it. Prove me wrong.
The one round where they do it, of course. Well, I mean, I think FXGO would pretty pick up an AWP if he felt like there was a lot of pressure on the team, like they were losing. Maybe that would be his go-to thing, but it might be more fun playing with an orb at this point for him. Or not without an orb, I mean just with a rifle. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Nice shot. Hunden going to take down. Look at that, he's actually sat on the couch. Brilliant. Time for a screenshot. He actually got sat down up in the apartments. Yeah, you're going to have to go free view and check that.
Yeah, I'm going to look right now.
It is perfect. Well, MSL looking through the smoke last time. He got a double flashbangs through. MSL realizes what's happening, but he is so flashed. Going to go down, and this was working out really well. SF eventually dies, but it's still going to be a 2-on-3, and FXGO hiding inside right by oranges. If they don't check this corner, he can win the round all on his own, and they won't check it. Bomb not going to be going down here. FXGO just peeks, gets the one, flashes in as well. Oh my god. Really nice way to handle it. Then he casually jumps away, and PNX in a tough call here. 1-on-2, he does get the kill. But now Shoxi's right here, so when he goes for the bomb, probably going to be the end of him. Has a grenade out, and what?
That's not like Shoxi. Is that his brother playing or something?
I don't know. Maybe he's just playing with like one hand or something. He's just a trackpad instead. I mean, there's no time here for PNX. He has to go for a straight defuse. He can't fake it anymore, and Shoxi really knows that. He's actually going to try and burn him. That's just really bad-mannered, but he gets away alive and actually gets the headshot. Shoxi utterly failing that round, and credit to PNX for actually staying alive and getting that one. 7-4 here.
If that was a big round, I probably would go hard on Choxi, but it probably doesn't matter. If they end up losing or tying, then remember it. We will blame Choxi.
Yeah. If we had had... I'm trying to imagine what TM would have said if he had been here. I don't even know. I guess we can't really say it on stream without getting banned, but...
Yeah, you don't want to know.
Something horrible. Truly. This time, MSL actually does burn to death, so... Epsilon, they get to fry themselves some Danes. And unfortunately for unu AiN, Epsilon can still buy him. I mean, I think that's the most... When you're struggling on the T side to even get a few rounds in and you finally get one, it is kind of devastating realizing that the other team can still buy because you've been, you know, waiting so long to pick up a round. And that's kind of what they're at right now.
Well, oftentimes, you know, sometimes losing a round actually is worse for you. You know, you win that one round and then you lose the next and you're back at square one. You're back at getting the lowest amount of money you can. You're back with nothing. Yeah. So... You know, as I said, sometimes winning a round actually turns into something bad for you.
GMX with a pretty cool shooting gallery going on. He was flashed in by a teammate. Just, again, basic teamwork coming out here from Epsilon, but it is working really well. A great double kill from GMX, and now Tensky, well, in a pretty bad position, especially because they're covering the bomb. But let's see if he could do some damage here. Going to take down one. They peek again, and this time it's going to work. Kiyoshima will take him down, and we're looking at an 8-4 scoreline in favor of Epsilon.
Yep, and just as we said, unu AiN won the round, lost the next. RIP, unu AiN. Goodbye, your money.
That is kind of what you were pointing out, and we see it happening right here. Definitely unfortunate for them, especially, I think, Kunden down to 1,200, and that's just not a lot. Now they're going to be rushing right into FXO, and a good flashbang comes out, actually. Like the fact that he even invested in them, but... He's going to counter flash, and GMX will take one up from behind here and gets a quick second. So in spite of some good work early on, it's not going to be enough. And Choxi just casually going to click them away with the M4A4 and put us into the 14th round. I feel like, I mean, I don't know if you agree, Hiko, but I feel like even if this finishes 16-6, which was the score that Epsilon got against VODS Pro, those two games sound really comparable. I think you've already, you know, sort of alluded to the idea that Epsilon probably aren't taking this game just as seriously.
Yeah, especially, I mean... You have to think, like, you beat a team like NIP, and then you go in and play a team like, I don't know, we'll say USSR, because we already cast them on today. Yeah. Like, just after that, it's just kind of like, it feels so easy. The feeling is just not there. You put all your heart into winning the last game, and now they're playing a team that's a lot less skilled than them, and they probably just don't care at all.
Well, maybe they should. They've been losing some players left and right here, but Choxi is still alive, and last time he sort of flew around the way. This time, saving a few bullets, still going to go down. Almost shot out of the map by that one, so nice headshot from PNX. And that's going to be a double for the Danish player now. FXO is going to be charging in, but I think they've already heard him. He's not really in a good spot here. I mean, this is one of those... I would say this is a big sign of how little Epsilon worry at the moment. Because normally you would wait for your teammate, wouldn't you?
Yeah, he just walked in alone, casually trying to kill... All three of them alone.
Kiyoshima, maybe with a little bit more respect, gonna try and see if he can run away. Well, there it is.
And you have to look at them. If you look at the money, he kind of needs to save. I feel like if they all had money, he definitely would just go and try to aim map them and see if he can win it.
Try and aim map them. Is that the term?
That's what we call it. Yeah, they're just aim mapping at this point. They're just pushing us and just trying to fight us. It's just like playing an aim map.
Okay, that's a good term. I actually like that term. That says a lot about what's happening. I think that's a really descriptive term. Okay, well, we're moving into the 15th round. And if you're just joining us on the game, we're going to have a halftime about 30 seconds. And then second half's coming up. No breaks at all, really, apart from those 30 seconds. And we'll see if unu AiN can come up with 6 rounds here in the first half. Definitely... I mean, the Danes are hitting some good shots. It's not really the aim, I think, that's lacking here. It's just one of those things, again, when you're up against a team that is sort of significantly better than you are, it gets a little bit tough.
Yeah. Just look at what they're doing. They're just doubling in, like, the opposite pool, just fighting. Yeah. And they both get killed for it.
Yeah.
But...
Not exactly ideal. Now, FXO, again, just flashing and charging right through... Bomb plant going to be delayed, actually, but he goes down anyway, so looks like we will, in fact, finish 9-6 here.
Yeah, it's looking that way so far. You still have two smokes in the Terror's hands, but...
Bit of an execution coming out from DMX. Tenski looking the wrong way, not ideal, but they still have the advantage here. They should be able to do it. MSL with a triple kill. Let's see if he can break through and actually get another one. Choxy trying to walk through the smoke. He's very close to the bomb, but he's going to go down. Shot to death in the corner. 9-6 for the first half here.
Like, I mean, to be completely honest with you, 9-6 really isn't that bad of a score. I mean, unu AiN, I guess, could win this, but Epsilon were kind of just throwing away rounds, and they weren't really, I mean, we've been saying it the whole time, they're really not trying as hard as they probably should. So, yeah, I would still have to give it to Epsilon, though.
I agree. I think it's, you know, I don't want to take anything away from the Danes, but I don't think they would disagree either if they were here on the stream that probably it's been Epsilon playing you know, a lot different than they did against VODS Pro. But you know, you got to be careful at least. There's no reason to throw away a game at any point. This is, you know, the SLTV Star Series, of course, and you know, points matter at the end. It's only four teams that get invited. So if you want to go to the LAN, and there is quite a bit of money. I'm not exactly sure what it is, but I think it's like 40,000, isn't it? It's like,
I don't know,
30 or 40. I think it's a fair bit anyway. So you don't want to just throw away a ticket to the LAN finals, of course, and especially not if you are Epsilon and you consider, you know, unu AiN to be one of the easier teams. You definitely want to stack up points on the easier teams and not just, you know, throw them away.
Is it round based or just win loss based?
Win loss based, I'm pretty sure.
Okay, because I was gonna say, if they're throwing rounds and it's round based, then that's kind of stupid on their part, but.
Oh, MSL with a great pickoff here. Tenski is going to get rushed down, and he smartly falls back. This is a really nice move. Flashbang goes in. Tenski still staying alive. This is really important, but can't say the same for Kevin. He goes down. Now, unu AiN actually rushing up behind, all the way from the B bomb site there, just coming in here, and MSL has to find another kill. He will pick it up, but he goes down right afterwards. Now it's Tenski and Hunden left. Bomb is down. 2-on-3 here. And Hunden missing that shot. Going to be have to try and take up, go down against Shoxy again. He needs to pick up this kill, otherwise it's not going to work out at all. There's one from Tenski. Hunden still hesitating. Shoxy playing a dangerous game. Yeah.
Oh.
And there it is.
You just have to laugh.
Yeah.
Shoxy just blatantly just like trolling, just making him miss, and then he just one shots him afterwards.
Oh man, 6-10, and. Even if they'd won that pistol round, unu AiN, it would have still been pretty difficult for them to win. But losing it means, what are we looking at here? We're looking at a 12-6 scoreline before they can realistically buy. And yep. Epsilon, I mean, they showed us before how good they can be on the T side. So this is going to be very tough, I think.
Yeah, and we're seeing Epsilon still playing that passive round on the eco rounds, which is what we were talking about against VODS Pro. I do like that. Don't have to get any overly aggressive, just play passive, get the picks. They already got MSL now, and looks like they're just going to walk up B. Or they're falling back.
Either way, or no matter... Not. Oh, that is actually a really good pickoff, but Shoxy down the middle is going to return, and see if Hunden can do it once again. He's going to peek again with the P250, not going to be enough this time, but still credit to him for getting that first one on GMX. That looked like a really good shot. Kevin may be able to pick out SF. Is he at the right timing? SF just kind of running and jumping at the same time and goes down for it. And then it's Shoxy's turn. So 11-6, and be very surprised if the Danes buy this round. I think that'd be a big mistake.
Yeah, they can't afford it. I mean, they couldn't get it. They would have to get Colts or Famuses and nothing else. But yeah, they're saving.
Into the 18th round is what we're looking at, and I don't know. I kind of want to see unu AiN just try and play it a little bit standard once they get rifles. But if that doesn't work, I'm hoping that they're, you know, quickly going to try and switch it up and maybe just throw in some true madness. Something that maybe Epsilon won't expect, because I think one of the worst things is seeing you know, a team that's worse just continuing to play their standard game and losing, you know, never really changing it. Because, I mean, I think playing standard against equal, you know, against an opponent is a good idea if they're, like, equal to you. But if you're much worse, it might be a bit of a mistake, I think.
Yep. And now we're into that same thing we saw earlier. Epsilon doubles unu AiN's rounds. Will unu AiN bring it back this time, though? That's the question. Here's the round to win if they want a chance. They actually have an op too on Kevin, if that's what you called him.
Yeah, it is Kevin, and I'm definitely liking Kevin as an orb. He seems to be really aggressive, and he hits some good shots, but just to say that, I think I may have cursed him. He missed that one. MSL's dead to defend him. Bomb is down as well. MSL coming out with a kill and almost going to be a double, but they give up a bit of the B-bomb site. Kevin going to have to rotate back towards Flowers, and Hunden rotating in, but he's getting smoked off here. Kevin gets another shot at doing this, but, well, I'm sorry for cursing you that much, Kevin. That grenade outright killed him. Now, Hunden charging through the Molotov. Takes down FX Job. It's back into a 2-on-2.
Hunden there is actually a good play. Well, unfortunately, they let him plant. But if they would have pushed while the one guy was planting, I mean, in a 2v2, one guy plants, one guy has to hold. And there's two guys trying to retake it. So they had a chance there, definitely. Now they're kind of... Now they have the bomb ticking away. There's two smokes up. They have to try to get a quick pick here, or they really have no chance.
Shotzi gonna pick off one, and now Tensky goes down, so it doesn't work out. But I agree, and actually Hunden has been playing pretty well. He's been hitting some good shots, and that rushing through the Molotov is a good idea. Because, I don't know, I mean, to me it almost feels like when someone puts down a Molotov, sometimes they just assume that means that corridor is blocked. No one's going to be coming. So if you rush through, it's almost like you're actually using... You're using that fact against them. You're sort of using it mentally against them, which is a cool little thing.
Yep, it definitely is a lot about timing, too. I think when you throw a Molotov, people hold it for a second, and then they kind of leave it. So if you push at the right time, normally you'll catch somebody off guard.
Well, another kill coming in from Hunden over at Banana, but they do lose MSL in the meantime. And obviously they're ecoing here, so there's a good chance this could be 14-6 at this point before... The Danes can pick up rifles again. And they have got this one AK, so if they push into the AK, it could actually maybe work out for unu AiN. I've never figured out how that name came to be.
unu.AiN. I couldn't even guess what it stands for either.
No, I really can't either. I have no idea. We'll have to interview them at some point and ask them, or I'll try and get them on Steam or something. Figure out what's going on. Epsilon back to playing slowly, 40 seconds on the clock, and it will be the push for Hunden's position. He's going to flash out a little bit too early. I wish he would have saved that flash and actually peeped behind it, because this is not going to be easy. They know exactly where he's even had grenades. Great headshot coming out, and he's still alive, buying more time for his teammates to get here. Grenade without any body armor, that's how much damage it does. That's actually one of the reasons why you really want body armor, because those grenades are painful otherwise.
Yeah, and it looks like... unu AiN actually has a chance to win this round. It's a 2v3. They don't have the bomb down yet.
Oh, and right around the corner, PNX going to be charging in. And there it is. No bomb plant either. Great job.
Yeah, good job holding off the plant. That was an eco round they won. So now they'll definitely have full guns. If they can win another round or two like that, you know, maybe they'll be able to have Epsilon on the ropes and maybe be able to come back into this. They're down so much now, though. Like, they have to win a few rounds in a row to even have a chance.
Yeah, we don't want that ugly pattern that we were talking about earlier, where you would just win the one round and then you're back to losing. That's the worst thing that can happen. Because in case you're new to the game and you don't know how the economic system works, it works like this. When you lose one round, you get 1,400, and then it climbs every time you lose until you get actually 3,400 for losing. That's after losing five rounds in a row, you'll get that much for losing. But then when you win a round, it resets and you're back to, you know, the $1,400 loss. And that's the problem. A big problem if you lose and win and then lose. And PNX lost his head. And also, Kevin, same fate for him. Hunden and MSL, well, they're choosing to eco and I can't, save, and I can't really blame them.
Yeah, Epsilon has a good hall square. One of their guys just jumps up in boiler, and then another guy goes through the halls. And they were able to kill the guy at the end of halls first, and then the guy boiler just really didn't even stand a chance. I mean, he really couldn't do anything.
Yeah, timing working out absolutely perfectly for Epsilon this round. GMX did go down, but apart from that, just not much working out for the Danish team. And at this point, 14-7, again, they're doubling the round score here, Epsilon. What's the reasonable play from unu AiN? I mean, did they keep trying to hold it like they have, or is this the time to go for something really, really insane?
I mean, the eco round they won, they had a guy push halls. They had a guy push down mid as they were going B. So playing passive hasn't worked for them at all, either half. So maybe try to play aggressive. It looks like Kevin has an op again, though, and it, which he wasn't very... He got nothing done with it the last time he had one. And yeah. You can't play aggressive if you have an op either, for the most part, unless you're JW. But...
it's a big risk, especially when you're this far behind. It's such a valuable weapon that even though maybe the smart thing is to play aggressive because you want to catch someone off guard, it takes a lot of confidence. And you know, unu AiN can't have that much confidence left considering how far behind they are. Kevin actually could have... yeah, he did leg shot GMX. Very nicely done. That was in spite of the flash coming out, so some pretty good reactions there. But is it going to be enough? It's the question we need answered right now, and Epsilon are looking to answer it by rushing this A bombsite, all of them out of apartments, just charging in here, and they let them down in the pit. That's a big problem, though. Great recovery here. Kevin with a good shot. Tensky picks off one, and Kevin with another kill coming in. Finally, they take him down, and SF almost sprays down too, but he's now alone in the bombsite. Gonna go down. Very good retake and very good defense.
Yeah, that's kind of a funny round. I mean, four guys jumped out the halls, two guys made to the site, and then the last two went pit, and they died. And while there were two guys still alive in the site, that was just kind of awkward.
So some guy in the chat, Paradox, saying that unu AiN stands for you need us, awesome is nothing. Actually, that clears up nothing for me at all.
Yeah, like, yeah, I don't get that at all.
I have no idea.
I mean, I can make up something to sound weird too if I wanted to. The question is, what does it actually stand for?
I don't know. Maybe that's what it stands for, but I still don't understand the significance. FXJO is going to pick off Hunden, and that's a big problem. Hunden playing really well the last couple of rounds. They don't want to lose him, of course. Good flashbang coming out here from Tensky, and then PNX to peek. But now he's sort of trapped behind this column. Kevin going to come and try and help out, but if he moves right now, Shoxi is staring right at him. I think Shoxi even knows he's going to be there. So he's just going to be walking in here. PNX still hiding. Good patience coming out here from the Danish player. Doesn't help, and Shoxi sprays. That was like a 270 degree angle that he just held down mouse one and picked up the second kill. Now Kevin already getting a double. He's gonna have to get two more to win this round.
21 HP, stuck behind a smoke in the library. Does he have a chance, Anders?
There's always a chance, Hiko. There's always a chance, but I would say it's, you know, bordering on minimal at this point. Another smoke. Oh my god, I have the hiccups now. It's terrible. This is not the time to have hiccups. Why?
You want to know the remedy?
Yeah, go on, tell me.
Okay, here's what you do. Hold your breath as long as you can. Just when you think you can't hold your breath anymore, take a drink of water or whatever you have. It'll fix it 100%.
100%, you say?
100%.
You know what the bad thing is? I actually don't have anything to drink, which is like, that's like the one thing you can't do if you're casting is not have anything to drink nearby. That's asking for trouble. I'll see if I can fix it either way. Maybe it's gone away on its own. MSL just gonna... actually, Hunden pick up that kill, but it could have been MSL as well. So just Epsilon charging through smoke and into fire. Not really the ideal situation. And we'll see what's going to happen here. Hunden looking for a rifle to pick up here. They really don't have a lot on the Danish side, and it's match and map point for Team Epsilon, looking to take the second victory of the night, the first one against VODS Pro. Great pickoff from FXJO so fast that even though Kevin was actually waiting there with an AWP on the other side, it wasn't enough.
FXJO is actually one of those AWPers that's fun to watch. You don't really find many AWPers that are fun to watch, but he is one of the few. Him, JW, who else is there?
Yeah.
There's other people, but...
I don't know. I think... I don't know. I like Nico opping when he's actually playing Counter-Strike, but obviously he sort of comes and goes. But you're right. Some AWPers are less interesting. I think, you know, the most... actually a really effective style of AWPing, but one that isn't all that fun to watch is the style that Kucha has on...
The passive AWPer, yeah.
Yeah, he's just holding an angle, but he's just very good at it. It's super effective. It's just not very sexy, but... Tensky goes down. Sorry, we're just talking here, but obviously Epsilon winning this round here. Kiyoshima picking down a triple kill at the end, and it's 16-8. Still a better score than VODS Pro got, but again, it's not really clear if we can actually compare those two games. But guys, that's going to be it. That's the last game of